Well, it was a funny situation because I had been working on this business plan for a really long time, since 1996. And I remember sitting at the kitchen table with my partner, Mike, and the front page of the New York Times Magazine said, you know, artisan ice cream movement, Humphrey Slocum in San Francisco. And I was like, you know those moments where you're like, that was my idea. I wanted to do this. I've been wanting to do this. And he just looked at me and said, well, you should do it. And it's, you know, when you have someone kind of call you on it, it's nice. One thing to walk around with this business plan, it's very safe for 10, 12, 15 years, but it's another thing to put yourself out there. I think especially as a woman, you know, women are famous for wanting to perfect things. And so here I am walking the streets, hitting the streets in 2011, the height of the recession, with this business plan, going to banks thinking I'm gonna get funding. I sincerely thought I might get a loan, and I didn't. And I just thought, this isn't gonna happen, it's fine, you know, file it away. And I was in my home office one day and I came across this paperwork and it said 401k. And I've been in working for really large, you know, international companies my entire career. And so I had a nice 401k and I thought, ah, I do have money. And without hesitation, I cashed it in, maxed out my credit cards, sold my house, had a garage sale, and kind of cobbled together all the money I had. But we were $40,000 short at the last minute, and Mike, who hadn't known me very long, put his house up for collateral to secure a loan from the city of Portland. So it really ended up being a group effort, and we were able to open. And we were on such a shoestring budget, but when you're getting started, you have no idea what these costs are gonna be, even though I had done a lot of research and gone through it in detail with other friends who have done similar things. There are always surprises. I've come to accept that now, 8 years later.